Hi everybody, this is Priscilla Hole with the Osho Tarot reading for the new moon that was actually on March the 8th in 2016. It was actually the day of the solar eclipse. I think it was March 8th in the US and March 9th here in Australia. So I actually owe everybody a massive apology. It's been a massive, massive week, so all about the massive. Huge energies and a very challenging time to stay on top of everything. There was just so much going on. And I had every intention of doing the reading, and then one thing would lead to another and it just didn't work out, or the rain came in and who knows. Anyway, here I am, finally getting it done, and here's a card for everybody. New moon, a time of closing out old stuff and setting intentions for the next cycle in Pisces around very watery sign, very sort of ruled by Neptune, very interesting time of energy. And also with the actual eclipse, the solar eclipse that we had, about like, you know, covering up what's normally has light shone on it. And then with a new phase coming through, things that you wouldn't have been able to see before are going to start to reveal themselves. So you'll find that this next 6 month period from that solar eclipse is going to start to reveal a lot of stuff for you. Things that you may not have been aware of in the past, and now they're suddenly all starting to come to the light. This is a collective thing. No one is exempt. It's being shown in the world of politics, in the world of banking, and in our own worlds personally, of course, and in family. Okay, so I'm just going to draw a card for you all. Oh, I'm just wondering which one's going to jump up to the surface. Okay, here we are. So this card is about consciousness and how do we stay in that place of recognizing where we are. Are we stuck in a place of being tight and controlled, or are we going to be expansive? And it's letting us know that we have a choice here. So what I'm seeing here is being connected to more than just ourselves. So you can see the stars in the image of the Buddha here, and that one that particularly is shining out of the third eye. It's really showing that, you know, with our consciousness, we need to tune into ourselves, we need to tap into what's going on, but recognizing that we're also connected to the consciousness, the collective consciousness of the planet, and no one is exempt from this. We're all a part of it. It's like saying, you know, oh well, I'm separate from the ants and I'm separate from the animals, but we're not. We're no more separated from the stars than we are from any other animal on this planet, and our planet is a star. Technically it's a planet, not a star, of course, but you know, it's a part of the cosmos, and therefore it's telling me that it's all connected and nothing is separate. So when we connect with other people, looking at who we are as a part of that consciousness, a part of that collective, you know, where do we fit, what are we doing, what part of us is trying to create separation, and what part of us is afraid of the connection and the desire to separate from the consciousness of the collective. So it's a beautiful card. It's a good time to sort of go in and reflect and learn to listen to your inner voice and tune into that energy. It's really big. And as you can see here, there's an expansiveness to the shape of this Buddha. And it's going out into the starry night. And that just gives you that sense of infinity and hugeness. And that's really what we're a part of. We're a part of a really, really big process, a really big connection, really big. It's just so much bigger than us. I can't even find the words at the moment. So thank you so much for listening. I'm not sure if there's anything else I can add to this, but just have a good look at yourself and where you feel you're trying to separate yourself from the consciousness of the planet and the collective consciousness, and where do you feel that you're doing that for yourself. So come home, look at yourself, look at where you fit in the collective, and are you really listening to how that works for you? This is all a personal journey here. It's a very important one because we're all a part of the big picture. So how we choose to behave for ourselves in the bigger picture of everybody else, you know, recognizing that our decisions, our behaviours, our actions actually have an impact on the bigger picture of the collective consciousness. That's what I'm really getting. So when we do it with awareness, when we do it with clarity, and we do it with a sense of understanding of who we are in this bigger picture, there's a better flow for everybody, better flow for self, and a better flow for everybody else as well. Standing in your truth and standing in your integrity and coming from heart and not from mind. This is a really key thing. So I think that's about it for the moment. So I did try and finish it up a moment. All this information suddenly popped in and here it is. There's going to be the next full moon is going to be mental block. 23rd of March is the full moon here in Australia, and it's going to be the full moon in. The sun's moving into Aries. It's going to be the opposite sign of that, so I've got to look that up. There you go. I'm all over the place with my astrology. Thank you very much, everybody, and I'm hoping that you will get something from this reading, and I'll be, in a week's time, I'll have another one, so hot on the heels of this one. Thank you very much. Bye.